Boxing superstar Teofimo Lopez has announced his retirement today after his major win over Josh Taylor. Very, very few people gave him a chance. Very few. I could count the people who gave him a chance. Just to give you an example, Ring Magazine interviewed 21, and I've never seen this in all my years of boxing. Ring Magazine interviewed 21 fighters and experts and insiders before the fight, and all 21 picked Josh Taylor. I did a video 3 days ago. I posted it, and I said, nah, I respect Josh Taylor, but Teofimo's going to win. You just know. When you know, you know. So Teofimo Lopez says this morning, what a relief. Retired at the top. Thank you, boxing, for the amazing life you provided for myself and my entire loved ones. The double greatest. And it's kind of a shame because I remember when Teo, he was in a Mike Tyson podcast, and Teo won after he beat Loma, and he had all the belts. He said, my plan is to go up to 140. And at the time, Taylor had all the belts. And people thought that he was off his rocker. People didn't know what he's talking about. People doubted him. I wish he fought Taylor when Taylor had all the belts. He would have made history. Clarissa Shields is the only fighter in history on the female side or male side to be undisputed in two different divisions. Teofimo Lopez was robbed from that opportunity. He was actually, I thought he beat, when he fought Kambosos, one of the judges gave it to him. And he did say he had a life-threatening injury and people were doubting him. It just shows that he wasn't lying. Because Kambosos obviously is not that good. Teofimo had to be really, really with a life-threatening injury during that fight. And he was hospitalized for weeks after. So he came back. It's just like when he fought Nakatani, people knocked him and he came back and shocked the world right after. So Sandow Martin, people criticized him, came back and beat the number one guy in the division, Josh Taylor. This is Josh Taylor that beat Regis Progress, just to give you an idea. So, Teofimo Lopez, relieved this morning. He had to deal with a lot. He has to deal a lot. He said after the fight, in the ring, they asked him, well, what's his next fight? And he said he's going to court to fight for his son. He has a situation there with his ex that I wish him all the best. It's, I'm sure, a very, very tough situation. He loves his son. He gave him a shout-out on the air. And I wish him all the best with that, and I hope everything works out for him. A lot of people criticize Junior, Teofimo Lopez's dad. They said he needs a new coach. He doesn't know what he's doing. Listen, it's entertainment. The number one sports channel on YouTube is WWE, and they have 60-plus million followers on YouTube. And it's entertainment. So Junior brings you entertainment. Whether you love him or hate him, you pay attention to him. So, and look, to take a son that never threw a jab and make him a two-division champion, beating the number one guy each time, Ring Magazine always goes to the guy that beats the guy and the what's called like the lineal champ. And Teo did it twice. So actually after the fight, this is how it works normally in fights. When you see a guy in the fight, when beating the champion, normally 9 out of 10 times or 10 out of 10 times, the champion hands over, the team hands over the belt for the interview to the guy. And then back in the locker room, they give the guy back his belt because the belt has each one's name. And then what happens is, the sanctioning body will, most of the time, mail 3 weeks, 3 months, 6 months, a year, 2 years later, will mail the belt to the champions. Sometimes the sanctioning bodies, not WBC, because I've never seen them, but other sanctioning bodies, what they'll do is, they're so sure that the champion will win, that they're shocked when the other guy wins, and they don't bring a new belt to the fight. Sometimes they bring a new belt to the fight, and it's there, you see it in press conferences. And so yesterday, Team Josh Taylor, for some reason, they were kind of salty after the fight. And I understand the emotions run high. Teo wanted the Ring Magazine belt for the interview. And they wouldn't give it to him. And the editor in Ring Magazine, the editor-in-chief, Doug Fisher, said, hey, Teo, don't worry. I saw you send him a message. I'm going to get you your own belt with your name on it and everything. So that's nice to know that he's going to be taken care of and he's going to get his Ring Magazine belt. It was a very nice belt. Why not? Muhammad Ali had it. Mike Tyson had it. A lot of fighters like that. Of course, everyone loves any belt. I mean, people, if you could win a WBC belt, that's amazing. If you could win WBA belt, an IBF belt, WBO
doing what
belt
he
like
could
last night
to get his name.
Josh Taylor had all the belts and so vacated.
Congratulations to Teo and his dad.
So, we'll keep you guys posted, but right now, Teofimo Lopez, he means what he says. He's not one of those guys to just make a statement.
But right now, it's a break.
And not mean
take care of stuff that is way bigger than boxing.
If he says he's retiring, I believe him. And that's what he wants to do right now. Doesn't mean he can't come back in a year or two, 6 months, 2 months, 3 months, 3 years.
We'll keep you guys
right now, he just wants to walk away from boxing on the top, in his own terms. He has, as Mayweather would say, he has all his faculties.
Instagram.
He did it. And congratulations to him and his dad. It wasn't easy. It's a very hard sport. And he went to the Olympics with Honduras. And I met him before the Olympics. Him and his dad, they won Vegas sparring. And I knew right then this kid's special. And this kid's going places. Olympics didn't go too well. When he was signed, they didn't sign him as a superstar. They signed him just as another fighter. Nobody expected him from the promotion to do that well. And he did it on his own. He was getting the knockouts. He was bringing excitement. He was doing...
Ellie Sekback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.